guys, one more week together, and today I would like to talk with you about friend of God, enemy of the world. Let's start reading James 2, verse 23. And the scripture was fulfilled that says, Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness, and he was called God's friend. You know, the word says that Abraham believed God, and he received righteousness. You know, true righteousness cannot be developed by man, but only received from God by means of the work of the cross. Hallelujah for that. Further on in James, the Bible says that the one who wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. We need to understand that Christianity is not a religion which aims to lead people to a highly moral life according to the world's standards. You know, God did not come to produce a better human being. He came to produce a new being. When a Christian confuses the idea of sin with moral wrongdoing, he or she runs the risk of trying to live a life approved by people. But even this is not pleasing to God. You know, beside this, if we focus upon what is right or wrong in the eyes of people, we risk considering ourselves qualified before God, and we are not. You know, then we start to compare ourselves to other people instead of to God. The result of this attitude is that we begin to think we are good, and we get full of self-righteousness. And the problem is that a person full of self-righteousness is putting himself in the position of an enemy of God, an enemy of the work of the cross, because he is invalidating the work of the cross. The one who simply believes and receives the gift of righteousness by faith is called a friend of God. You are called to be a friend of God. And remember, you are greatly blessed, highly favored, and deeply loved.